Nazi dictator, a zero hour for withdrawing his troops from Poland. That zero hour ends now. At this time, we transfer you to London for an important announcement by the British Prime Minister.
Up to the very last, it would have been quite possible to have arranged a peaceful and honorable settlement between Germany and Poland, but Hitler would not have it. But a situation in which no word trusted, no people or country could feel itself safe, had become and against them, I am certain that the right will prevail.
6 hours after Great Britain declared war on Nazi Germany, the Republic of France followed. All France is in a maelstrom of activity. The Maginot Line has already opened fire on the Germans. The sparring is ended. World War II has begun.
At home, we were asked, what country do you consider responsible for causing this war? Germany, 82%. We Americans had no doubt who started it. Also, we began to feel...
From Sweden. From Spain. From North Africa. Scrap iron, as well as some iron ore, comes from the United States. These raw materials are needed for Britain's most important industry, her great blast furnaces and steelworks. For centuries, the furnaces of Britain have poured forth iron to be cast and forged and molded in British foundries. From the furnaces of Britain, too, come some of the world's best steel to be worked in British mills into beams, rails, plates, and other steel products. For Britain is one of the biggest of the world's iron and steel makers. Much of her metal goes to nearby factories where it is made into the finest of machinery, machine tools, and cutlery. Steel also goes to build ships. From Britain's shipyards have come more ships than from any other country in the world. Ships for the fleets of Britain and for the fleets of other nations. For another of Britain's industries, clay pits provide the raw material. Clay from the soil of the islands is worked by skilled craftsmen into a variety of shapes. The wool and the cotton go to supply the great textile mills of Lancashire and Yorkshire. Here they are spun into thread and woven into cloth. The weavers of Britain long led the world in cloth making and are still among the world's largest producers. In parts of the Isles, there are stretches of rich farm country. Here on the drier east coast, farmers for the most part grow grains, wheat, barley and oats. Elsewhere, potatoes are an important crop, and other vegetables are grown on the warmer southern coast. Much of the land is in permanent grass. Here, dairy herds are grazed, and fine beef cattle are grown, and brought to market in the country towns. Here, too, sheep are brought in from the rougher grasslands, all to be sold as meat for British tables. Food for British tables also comes from the sea. The fishing fleets bring in a plentiful catch, and people in the British Isles eat almost as much fish as meat. These products go chiefly to feed the people of Britain's cities, but they are not enough to fill her needs.